The start button is missing and I have no taskbar. What do I do? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're viewing this somewhere that has a like button when you get to the end of the video, why don't you give that thing a hit? That really does help everyone, including me of course, but it helps others find what they're looking for when they're searching for their answers. So you come across a Windows machine and it's running. Windows is clearly running, but there's no taskbar. What the heck? Let me show you a couple of the different things that could be happening and some of the things you can do to get it back. So here's my Windows 10 Pro machine. And you'll see that, of course, Windows is running. It's fine, but there's no taskbar. The first thing I would have you do is hit the Windows key. And sure enough, there's the start menu and the taskbar. All that really means is that the taskbar was hidden by a setting. Now we'll look at that setting in a minute, but the other way to get it back is, of course, just to move your mouse down to the bottom. And once you do, there it is. And you can start interacting with whatever's on the taskbar. And of course, you can hit the start menu by hitting the start button. The setting that's been changed here, I'll go ahead and right-click on the taskbar, click on Taskbar Settings. The setting that's turned on here is this automatically hide the taskbar in desktop mode. Literally, it hides the taskbar so you don't see it. It gives you that little bit of extra screen real estate for your applications to use and only shows you the taskbar when you hit the Windows key or when your mouse moves to that last row or last line on the screen. So I'm going to leave that turned on here just because it's a convenient way to use the entire screen. So what if that didn't work? What would you do? What could you do? The start button didn't do anything. The Windows key doesn't do anything. You move your mouse around the bottom, there's still no taskbar. The next thing to do is to type Ctrl+Alt+Delete. You can see that that switched us to this screen that allows us to do a couple of different things. The thing we're going to care about here is Task Manager. There's Task Manager. Now, I want the version that has more details because it also has more functionality. So here's Task Manager running. So click on File, Run New Task. Now the task I'm going to suggest you run is Explorer. Now that may seem counterintuitive and here's why. This machine is working. There isn't a problem. So if I run Explorer, we'll get Windows File Explorer. However, Windows File Explorer is also responsible for the taskbar and the start menu. If for some reason it's not running at all, then running it using Task Manager will cause the start menu and the taskbar to reappear. If that still didn't work, if running Explorer did not bring you to a Windows start menu or a taskbar, then we're kind of out of luck. We don't have a lot of things to try. What I recommend is that you run your anti-malware tools and perform a full scan. Now you might ask, well, how do I do that if I can't access the taskbar or the start menu? Well, unless you happen to have a shortcut on the desktop, and you'll notice that I don't here, you can run things via the command line because that is in fact all that File Run New Task is all about. Now, if you want to run Windows Defender, then you end up running %programfiles, Windows space Defender, mpcmdrun.exe, with a couple of options here, -scan and -scan type 2. I'm going to go ahead and create this task with administrative privileges and let it run. Now, you can see the scan is starting, and it's going to perform a full scan on my machine. Needless to say, that's going to take some time. Now, assuming that the anti-malware scan you run doesn't turn anything up, then nothing will have been repaired, of course. The next thing I would run is the system file checker. I have an article, What is the System File Checker and How Do I Run It? It's another command line utility that you would run using Task Manager's Run New Task. Next, if that doesn't work, then I'd attempt a refresh of Windows 10 itself using one of the techniques I've got outlined in Refreshing Windows 10 Without a Reinstall or Reset. Of course, if that still fails, then your only option could be reinstalling Windows from scratch. And the article on that is How Do I Reset Windows 10? But hopefully, one of these tools, one of these techniques, will get you back your taskbar, your start menu, and let you diagnose your problems from there. For updates, for links related to all this, including the article on which this video is based, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/2529. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.